never seen before from the arenas around the country.
That's going to be very exciting and a very exclusive feature for the Saturday morning broadcast here on TBS. But what else could you expect from TBS? The superstation gets its name and has earned it over the years. I'll tell you something, two other guys that have earned their reputation are Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard. The consummate tag team, in my opinion. They complement each other's style extremely well, and whether you like J.J. Dillon or not is really irrelevant. But he is a mastermind. He is a tremendous, tremendous individual when it comes to laying out a game plan. Arn Anderson has buried that left hand, and I've mentioned on many broadcasts, if you want to see some impact, keep your eye on that big left ham of Arn Anderson.
He nailed him, and now Lee Peek comes in to remind everybody, you know, we've been talking about the Horsemen and the situation with Lex Luger. We're going to be talking, David Crockett will be talking with Lex Luger a little bit later on in this hour, but also Luger now, not a member of the Four Horsemen, and Ric Flair was out here talking about Barry Windham, and Barry Windham possibly becoming a member of the Horsemen. Now that's all talk from Ric Flair. Barry Windham has never commented on the situation to us.
No, and I'll tell you something, I'm really interested to find out what his reaction is to that, but he has got his hands full, and perhaps more so, with Larry Zbyszko and Baby Doll. Zbyszko is obsessed to winning the Western States Championship. And talk about obsession. Championships and the life in the fast lane, as the old Eagle song goes, is a way of life with Ric Flair, Tully Blanchard, Arn Anderson, and J.J. Dillon. That man, the leader, and I'll tell you, I got to take my hat off to him. He is a tremendous, tremendous influence for the Four Horsemen. And whomever they choose, you can bet they may take a little bit more time than they did with Lex Luger. Who knows?
Arn Anderson standing there. We saw just moments ago, perfectly executed dropkick from Tully Blanchard that led to the downfall Lee Peek. And now Arn Anderson using every method that he knows, and he knows a bunch of them, putting Peek to the other side. Arn Anderson with that elbow right on the chest. Anderson reaches in, goes right back to the corner. One of the keys have always been for these two men, keeping the opponent in their half of the ring. If you draw a line diagonally, neutral corner to neutral corner, you can find out that most of the action remains in the horseman's side.
And as great a strategist as they are, Tony, they're also very physically tough with very high thresholds of pain, because both men have qualified for the finals of the Bunkhouse Stampede on Sunday, January 24th at the Nassau Coliseum. They're great technicians, but they're also very, very physical. As we're seeing here, and Ed Franks, I'm sure, would testify of the physical nature. Well, there's an intense man right there, isn't he?
Watching on as his partner, Tully Blanchard, just pulls on Ed Franks. Tully Blanchard, he has been a champion many times over. And right now, as a tag team, there he is. Only thing he has to do is reach up and tag in Arn Anderson. Anderson with the left hand, right to the side of the head. Arn Anderson, the enforcer. And Jim Ross, you talked about that left hand. It's so devastating. And now, up on top they go.
Anderson, that great upper body strength, the big left hand once again, trying to take the air out of Ed Franks. And Ed Franks is in a very, very precarious way here as he falls to the canvas. January 24th could be one of the biggest nights in the history of the Four Horsemen. If Anderson or Blanchard win the thing, they're 500 grand richer, which is not bad in itself. And I think Ric Flair has got a lot to prove to the world. He does a lot of talking. He wears diamond rings and custom-made clothes. But it'll be man-to-man when he's in there with Road Warrior Hawk. And he doesn't care about diamonds or gold. He just cares about beating people up.
Yep, that's right. Anderson pushing Gary Phelps around, grabbing him by the ears, twisting the neck around, putting the man up against the rope to the other side. Here comes the spine buster. It's such an awesome move, and it's put Ed Franks down. Surely, if not for the count, it's very close by. And now Tully Blanchard doing the strut. JJ giving the signals. It should be and is. Here it comes, a slingshot suplex for Tully Blanchard. Over the top and down to the canvas. Count him out, because winners again, World Tag Team Champions, Tully and Arn. Awesome.
I've never seen them look any better than we're seeing right here. They're intense. They're gearing up. They know that January is one of the most important months in their athletic career.